Rorona, have you been to the catacombs?
The catacombs?
Have you ever even heard of it? It's that ruin near town that looks like a graveyard.
Oh, that place is called the catacombs? I haven't gone there. It's too creepy.
You can actually find many rare items there, like ingredients with spiritual powers that are especially valuable to alchemists. You should try going.
Really should. I'm kinda scared.
I've also heard many stories of ghosts being there.
The ghosts?
Yeah. Rumor has it they're super violent. Many wanderers have apparently been eaten by them.
Stop! You know I'm not good with that kind of stuff!
Oh, really? Oops, my bad. I didn't know that.
You don't sound convincing at all. Well, guess what? I'm not gonna go there anymore.
So you don't want the ingredients that can only be found there. That's too bad. Anyhow, it's up to you. But if you do decide to go, I can't guarantee your safety.
I said that's enough! Ugh, you're so mean!
We've got the first turn.
Tap!
Take this!
That was too easy!
We've got the first turn.
Angel Heart!
Take this!
Take it back to town with me? don't see anyone. Maybe I'm just hearing things. I better keep going. See one. King scared made me more tired than usual. I better go to bed. Oh, the teddy bear! Oh well.
I'll take care of it tomorrow.
Yesterday.
Good morning.
Huh? Is Master up already? I haven't even made breakfast yet. Oh, that wasn't Master. Who was it then?
You'd bring a ghost back with you. You're always exceeding my expectations.
Master, help! I'm gonna get eaten!
That's not going to happen. I made up that story.
I don't care! Just help me!
Wait, you made it all up?
Mm-hmm. It was just a little touch to scare you even more, and it worked like a charm.
Jeez, I don't eat people.
I apologize. I didn't mean to insult you, beautiful young ghost lady.
Oh, please. I'm not that beautiful.
What are you doing making small talk with her? She's a ghost! A ghost!
I don't get to talk to ghosts very often. I can't pass up this opportunity to actively engage her in conversation. Where are my manners? Here, have a seat. Rorona, can you prepare some tea for us?
Don't mind me. I can't sit or drink tea. I'm a ghost.
What is going on?
So, basically, you don't remember anything from when you were alive, Miss Pamela?
Oh, just call me Pamela.
She looks like a normal girl.
Okay, then. What are you thinking of doing from now on, Pamela?
I haven't really thought about it. I didn't really choose to come here.
She is a ghost. Wow, she doesn't have feet either. Just like a real ghost.
Then why don't you stay here until you decide what to do?
Are you sure? Thanks. That'll help me a lot.
Her hair is so fluffy. She's pretty cute, too.
Huh? What? Hair? No! Absolutely not!
Do you want to kick this poor, beautiful girl out onto the street? If so, then why did you bring her here in the first place?
It's not like I knew. Plus, she's a ghost.
And also, it's really weird of you to be so nice.
Well, excuse me. So are you saying that what I really want is to watch you be afraid of a ghost?
See? I knew it!
You're Rorona, right? Nice to meet you.
Stay away from me!
Excellent. This will keep things interesting for a while.
Thanks.
What?
Oh no, I'm so sorry. I've got the wrong house.
Wait.
No. This is my workshop, right?
Yes. This is your workshop, Master.
Master? Are you talking to me?
Why? Who are you? What are you doing here?
Ah, you're back? We've been waiting for you.
Master, there's a stranger here!
A stranger? That's not nice. That's your sister.
What? My sister?
Don't you remember? You said you wanted one, so I made one for you. You should be thanking me.
You made it? Wait, I'm confused.
It's basically a homunculus. What do you think? Looks just like a human, right?
What's a homunculus?
You don't even know that? Why don't you look it up yourself?
Fine. So...
Yes, Master?
What's your name? What should I call you?
I have yet to be given a name. Please call me whatever you like.
Yeah, why don't you give it a name?
I wasn't prepared for this. Well? No, that's... Well, I guess. No. This is hard.
Ugh, you're taking too long. Hum should be its name.
What? But I thought you were gonna let me come up with a name.
Understood. My name will be Hum from now on.
Aw, no! That's not fair, Master. You didn't even think about it.
Hum.
Actually, that's kind of cute.
Now that I have a name, I would like to start working. Master, please order me to do something.
Order? Like, give you orders?
Hum will obey us, no matter the circumstances. It already knows the basics of alchemy as well.
But Hum is just a little kid. I can't give orders to kids.
Its appearance is just my personal preference. Don't worry about it. Its mental and physical abilities are far beyond yours.
Then what am I gonna do?
My purpose for existing is to work for my master. Please, give me an order.
If you say so. I hope this is nothing like having a real sibling. it's coming from over there. Is he playing it? It's such a nice song. La la la. Oh!
Huh? Uh-oh, where did my audience go?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt you.
Well, well, there's no need to worry. That song wasn't meant for them. It was for a cute, precious girl like yourself.
What? Cute? Are you really talking about me?
Of course I am. Haven't you realized just how attractive you are?
I'm like totally gnome-like.
Don't look down. I can't see your beautiful face down there. What an interesting girl.
I have to get back to work now. Excuse me.
Wait, I have a question. A girl all alone in such a place. Is Arland nearby?
Oh, yes. If you go that way, eventually you'll...
I see. Thank you. I used to live there, but I forgot my way around. It's been a long time. Do you live in Arland?
Yes, I'm running the alchemy workshop there, so...
I hope we'll meet again. I'm looking forward to our dramatic reunion, my dear miss.
Oh, dear... I kinda like it. Oops, I really need to get back to work.
We've got the first turn.
Easy as pie.
Been a while.
Have you finally returned for good, my prodigal son?
You look like you're doing well. I expected to find you on your deathbed since you called me back so suddenly.
As for you, I thought you'd be found dead by the roadside by now. You've been gone for nearly 10 years without any contact.
Okay, no more lectures. There's a reason you wanted me to come back, right?
Yes. I thought I'd give you an important job.
A job, huh? I shouldn't have expected any good news from you.
Hmm? Did you say something?
Nope. So, what's this all about? I'm not up for anything boring, like a desk job, just so you know.
I don't need your help for that. It's the perfect job for someone like you, who doesn't know anyone in this town. Your job is to close down an annoying workshop.
A workshop? I see. Okay, I'll hear you out.
Timing. Here, this is a souvenir from our last trip.
Thank you.
never figured this out, but whose teddy bear is this? Has it always been yours? But this is about you.
Oh, you don't remember much, huh?
But you have to be near this teddy bear at all times, right?
No, I'm just comfortable with it around. But I can possess anything I want to.
Like a person?
I like objects better than people. I don't like sharing with another conscience.
Another conscience? Oh, no. Don't even think about it. I'm getting scared.
Ooh, that looks perfect.
You mean Hom-Hom?
Yes, Master?
Nothing, but you should stay away right now.
Excuse me now. Confirmed invasion by a foreign object. My body is...
Pamela, stop! You're gonna break Hom-Hom!
I wish I could, but something's stuck. This is going to be extremely dangerous. I must self-destruct as a last resort.
Whoa! No, no, no! I didn't know you could self-destruct!
Was Grandmaster's preference. There. I'm out. I have regained bodily control. I am shutting down self-destruct now.
Good. Are you okay? Does it feel weird anywhere?
I feel wrong. Everywhere. We must rest to restore.
Hom-Hom? You're just sleeping, right?
Get so worried.
It was all because of you.
I'm sorry. I'll restrain myself from possessing anyone else for a while.
For a while? Don't do it ever again.
Thank you.
Huh? I've heard this before. Ah! My ear!
Hello again, my dear kitty.
What's going on? My ear! I'm not a cat. I'm a human.
You seem pretty excited about it. You want me to try it on your other ear, too?
Ah, no! Don't! What are you doing here anyway?
You were in my dreams last night.
What?
I tried to get your attention, but then I realized that I don't even know your name. Do you know how heartbreaking it is when all you want is for that one person to notice you, but it's impossible?
Stop with that embarrassing talk. It's Rorona, okay? My name is Rorona.
Rorona? How poetic. It rings in my heart, even though it only has three syllables.
I said enough. Oh, but I don't think I've asked for your name either.
My name? I'm Tris... Wait, I guess I should keep it a secret, huh? Let's just say that my name is Tantris. Yeah, Tantris, the wandering bard-type person.
Tantris. Tris. They both sound awkward.
I didn't think you'd care so much about my name. Are you trying to send me some kind of signal?
What? No. I just need to figure out what to call you.
Aw, how cute. I'll never get tired of picking on you.
You bastard. Who gave you permission to create such a lovey-dovey atmosphere with my pupil?
Master?
My apologies. I didn't think I'd find another such beautiful lady here. Besides this precious girl, of course.
You make me sick. Wait, have I seen you somewhere before?
Ooh, straight to the point. Me likey. I heard you're suffering from an irrational order given by the kingdom. I just came to see if you need help.
You wanna help me?
Sure. I might not be of much help, but I can at least act as your shield. Just let me know. Anytime. Well, that's all. See ya.
He ran away.
It looked like he was running away from you, Master.
Whatever. I'm sure there'll be plenty of time to interrogate him later.
Master? Oh well, I'm tired.
Sis, it's unusual for us to run into each other like this.
Yeah. What are you doing?
Nothing. I was just taking a walk.
Oh, do you live in this town?
Of course I do. Did you just realize that?
Well, we've never met outside of my workshop before, so...
I've seen you outside several times.
Really? Why didn't you say hi?
I don't like associating with customers outside of business situations. With that said, see you later.
Oh, but it wouldn't hurt for him to be a little friendlier. find any food materials here.
Yeah, the only thing you might find here is... this thing.
A mushroom? They seem to grow everywhere.
Doesn't look poisonous. Come on, take it.
You don't like mushrooms, right?
Nope, they don't taste good. They're just some fungusy thing.
That doesn't sound very appropriate coming from a chef.
Oh, please, there are other things that taste better. Mushrooms aren't the only ingredients out there.
I think mushrooms are pretty good.
Here they come!
Take this!
Angel heart!
Looks like we've won.
We get the first strike!
Angel Heart!
And that's that!
My chance!
Yeah!
looks like my dear princess is gone.
That's right. I told her to run away before an evil sorcerer comes for her.
You are the one who's more like the evil sorcerer.
You got me there. Okay then, you're an evil wolf. No, maybe a dog is more suiting.
Man, that's harsh. Did I do something to make you hate me so much?
When I was a girl full of angst and body image issues, there was a brat who used to call me Four Eyes. Oh, how deeply that hurt my young psyche. Even with my big, generous heart, I'll never forget about that.
You've got an impressive memory. However, can you play along and pretend that we've just met?
That's your problem, not mine. However, I'll consider it, depending on what you're up to. It is something interesting, I hope.
I don't know what you're expecting, but I sure won't be trying to make it interesting on purpose.
That's too bad. Fine, I'll play along for now. It'll be perfect if I can use you as bait to discover that man's dirty secret.
I'm glad that you feel comfortable enough to say that in front of the bait. Well, thanks anyway. In return, may I take you out to dinner tonight?
No, thanks. I can't enjoy a good meal if I'm looking at a man's face. You'll only spoil it for me.
She turned me down. She's not gonna make this easy. I didn't think she'd turn out so nice. I guess I can't see the future as well as I thought.
We'll be right back. Rorona! Are you here? I have to ask you something!
Welcome.
Oh, am I in the wrong place? Pardon me. Wait, no, this is the right place. This is Rorona's workshop, right?
That's exactly what I said.
Rorona! Come on out here already! And who is that kid?
Hum-hum, one of Master's alchemy creations.
Alchemy creations? Don't be ridiculous.
My name is Han. Nice to meet you.
Oh, hi. I'm Cordelia. Nice to meet you, too. Hey, how tall are you?
4'8".
Upset, Lady Cordelia. Or should I call you Cory?
Ah! Don't scare me like that! And don't call me Cory!
I understand how you might be upset to hear that a newborn homunculus is already over 4'7". Especially given that you're only 4'6¾".
I'm not upset! Did you actually...
That's right. Just to make fun of you, I purposely made Hum 4'8" tall. Now go ahead and cry all you want.
Oh, you! This is so stupid!
You're only 4'6¾". Come on, join in, Hum.
Cory is shorter than me.
Oh, you won't get away with this! Not today!
Oh, Cory's pissed. Let's go, Hum.
Yes, Grandmaster.
Come back here! You're not getting away from me!
And now I'm left all alone. This is kind of sad.
Thank you.
Ooh, look at this thing.
Huh? What is it? An apple?
That's no ordinary apple. Here, try it out.
Okay, let me try it.
Is it really sour? I guess that's a stupid question. Here, drink some water to wash it down.
Water? You're so mean! I can't believe you made me eat that!
I'm sorry. I didn't think you'd react like that.
My tongue is still burning.
I should gather some for myself. Do you want some too?
No, thanks. I don't eat apples that are that sour.
They're only sour when they're raw, and they get really sweet when you heat them up.
Oh? Really?
I'm serious, and I'm not lying.
Fine, I'll take some too. But if you're lying...
I'm not. If they stay sour after heating them up, then you did something wrong. Coming right up!
Looks like we've won. Be careful.
Take this!
Tap!
We've got the first turn.
Take
You've got the first turn. No problem at all.
This'll make you dizzy.
Get away from this!
Angel Heart!
Harder than I expected.
Thank you.
that? Make you dizzy?
I've got it. I've got it. Here I come!
Looks like we've won.
Sweet! We get the first strike! Coming right up!
I've got it!
Looks like we've won.
Coming right up!
know how to make a ghost feel good about herself, you know?
I'm starting to get used to it, but it's still a little scary. So, do you need something?
Yes, I'm really bored. Do something about it.
Well?
The only thing I can do here is scare you all day long. I mean, don't get me wrong. That is pretty fun.
Stop, please. I'll think of another way for you to waste your time.
Do you promise? I'm looking forward to it.
Shopping here too?
Sure. Something like that. Anyway, I gotta go.
She's been acting weird lately. I wonder if something happened.
Yeah. So what did she buy?
She came here to sell her stuff, like clothes and accessories.
Really? Is she broke?
Sure. I don't want to be too nosy, you know?
Now I'm
came to watch us again? You must have too much time on your hands.
Well, I do have things to do, but your show is really fun to watch. Thank you.
Hey, don't flatter her too much.
Leonella never feels flattered, but compliments make her even more nervous. Oh, I'm sorry. And when we point that out to people, she starts to get depressed, like so. I've always wondered, why do you do these shows if you're so shy? That's exactly the reason. She started doing this to get over her shyness.
I know it's hard to believe, but she has improved a lot since she started.
So she used to be even worse?
Yeah, she was like a stray cat. If you had tried to get near her, she would have hissed and scratched you.
I never did that.
Hey, don't scratch me.
See, just like that. Oh, do I need to be careful too? No, you're okay, I think. Are you sure?
Hey, don't just stand there and watch. Help me out. She's about to tear out my stuffing.
Seems like Tiffany is sick, and the shop is closed.
Really? She is pretty frail, and she works way too hard.
Her helplessness is one of the many things that I like about her.
Hey, that's inappropriate!
I know, but I'm sure you've all thought about that before, too. Taking care of Tiffany while she's sick in her bed. You bastard! How dare you say such filth! Man is allowed to fantasize.
Aw, stop fighting. I'm worried about her. I should bring her some medicine later.
Thank you.
Thank you for visiting me. I'm sorry that I'm so busy right now.
Don't worry. It's enough for me to just watch you work.
Please don't say stuff like that.
Well, what should I do? I don't intend to interfere with their business here. But if I don't do anything, he won't get off my back. May I ask you a question? You don't have to stop doing what you're doing.
Sure. What is it?
Have you been having any problems recently? Something related to work, perhaps?
Problems related to work? Oh, one time I couldn't buy an item that I wanted because someone else bought the entire shop's supply.
Huh. Sounds like he's not doing anything overtly ridiculous.
So, I went to gather it myself. The shop ended up buying the rest from me at a higher cost because it was so scarce. Wait, so I guess that was a good thing after all.
You're not so clever, old man. Anything else?
Well, weird things have been happening around here lately. Like, someone put a thumbtack inside a flask and swapped the sugar with salt.
Besides the thumbtack, the salt and sugar might have been your own mistake.
Do you think so? Master said the same thing.
Anyway, I should get going soon. Sorry to bother you at a busy time.
Problem. I'm sorry I couldn't do anything.
Let's plan a day to hang out. Just you and me. Alone.
Ah! Please don't whisper so close into my ear!
See ya.
Ugh, I wish you would stop fooling around like that.
Master, your face is a bright red, and strange smoke is coming from the cauldron.
Huh? Oh no!
I was gonna try to help her if he was doing anything ridiculous, but it sounds like he's no big deal. So what should I do now?
Thank you.
should bring this medicine to Miss Tiffany. Miss Tiffany, this is for you.
Huh? Is this medicine?
Yes, I heard you were sick again, so I thought you might want to keep this in your cabinet.
Oh, I'm sorry for making you worry. How much is it?
Oh no, it's not like you asked for it. I want to give it to you as a thank you present for being so kind to me all the time.
Well, okay. Thank you so much. I'm actually still a little sick.
Well, please get some rest and feel better.